Welcome back to United Tradesman Academy. Hey guys, look, I gotta put a 1-inch conduit EMT in this wall right here. Right here in this wall, I have to put a 1-inch conduit in this wall. It's gonna be for a steamer. This room right here is gonna be like a sauna. So the steamer is gonna be inside of here. It's gonna be inside of here. So I'm gonna run my conduit through the wall, up the wall, and I'm gonna 90 it out above the ceiling. The ceiling is gonna be 9 feet. So I gotta do a 90 at the top up here and 9 feet from the floor. And I also have to do a 90 right here. It's gonna go up the wall. So I'm gonna start my 90 right here. I'm gonna start my conduit run right here, come through here, and I'm gonna 90 up, straight up the wall. And then, like I said, when I 90 up the wall, I'm gonna 90 up the wall. Hold up. I'm gonna 90 up the wall, and I'm gonna 90 out. So, very simple process, but sometimes it can be misunderstood. I'm gonna give you the short, easy method. I'm not gonna include all the geometry that you would get in a school. I'm just gonna show you a simple measuring tape, and you're gonna use a pencil to measure your conduit. You're gonna use a pencil to mark your conduit with your measurement that you're gonna have for your 90. And we're gonna use the conduit bender right there. That's all we're gonna do. Guys, so like I said, my pipe is gonna start right here. So I need to get a measurement from the start of my conduit back to over here to this wood stud right over here. So right now, I'm at about 41 inches. So my measurement was 41 inches. So I'm gonna go to my conduit, my EMT 1-inch conduit. I'm gonna measure 41 inches. Now, I don't wanna just bend it at 41 inches. I wanna do what's called a 90 degree deduct. So the deduct for 90 degrees for a 1-inch conduit is gonna be 8. So when you deduct, that means you're taking away. Deduct means taking away from something. So we got the measurement again, which is 41. Yep, 41 inches. So we don't wanna go, so we wanna go 41 minus 8. That's all we're gonna do. So let's go 41 minus 8. So 33 inch 90. So like I said, our first mark is gonna be at 41. Then we're gonna put another mark where we're gonna deduct 8 inches from that, which is gonna be 33 inches. So that's where we're gonna put the arrow mark on the bender to bend at 33 inches. Okay guys, now, so we said 41 inches was our first original measurement, 41. Now we're gonna go, that second measurement is gonna be 33. That's where we're gonna put our mark at. That's where we're gonna bend the pipe. That's 33 inches. So our first mark was at 41. That's 41. Our deduct is gonna be minus 8, 33 inches. Now let's look at this bender here. If you see that arrow right there, that's where
we're gonna put our bender at. So the arrow needs to match up with that first mark, the deduct at 33 inches.
You're gonna need a level for this also. Put the level right there. You're gonna need some foot pressure for this right here. Some foot pressure. 1, 2, 3. Just like that. 1, 2, 3. You gotta use foot pressure. Because if you don't, once you take this bender off here, you're gonna have kinks in your pipe. I'm shifting my body weight back. I'm throwing my body back, on that bender. Now you want to keep an eye on your level. Because what we're going to be looking for is that bubble to go right in between those lines. So we're just a little bit overbent, which is fine because we can take that out. So let's show you what we're looking for here. So you can see that level is back that way. So what we wanna do, we just wanna take a little bit out. And there we go. Now, we're at level on that level. Okay, so what was our first measurement? 41 inches. So now we're gonna take our measuring tape just to confirm that our bend is correct. 41 inches. Okay guys, so let's see how this conduit looks in the wall. That's right where it needs to be, right there. Now it goes up the wall. And we're gonna turn another 90 out. All right guys, look, very simple process. Learning a new trade is kind of like learning a new martial art, because a lot of these movements, you're not used to using your body all together at one time to complete one movement. But sometimes when you're doing a movement in a karate form, we call a kata or kata, one form, it could be whether you're defending or whether you're attacking. You know, it's not a broken down movement. It's not like move over here, move over here. It's a one flowing movement. You know, so it's the same way with learning how to bend conduit, learning how to pull wire. You're using your body in unison, your wrist, your elbow, your legs. You're using all these together to perfect one movement, to defend yourself or to attack against somebody. So learning a new trade is like learning a new form of martial art. So guys, look, I'm not going to take up too much of your time. Hey man, look, if y'all out there just getting started in the trade, you got to stick in there. Look, I'm not a pro at doing HVAC. I'm striving to become better every day, but look, if we strive to become better in our lives, guys, look, your family benefits from it, you benefit from it. So guys, look, have a good day, have a blessed day. We'll see y'all next time back at United Tradesman Academy.